Hello and welcome to my ArduMower perimeter tutorial. In this tutorial I want to explain how the perimeter recognition of the ArduMower works. Why do we need a perimeter? I have here now maybe my lawn which I want to mow, and if here is my robot. And I don't want that the robot is leaving this area. Therefore, I install a perimeter wire around the lawn. Here. And now I'm be able to recognize if the mower runs over the perimeter wire. And if I recognize this, I can drive back and mow in another direction. Okay, how this works? I will delete this, therefore. First, I want to draw the perimeter wire again. Here, this is my perimeter wire, and then I need a sender, which produces the perimeter signal. This is a sender connected to the perimeter wire. Sender. I have only my mouse to draw, therefore it's not so beautiful. And to explain now what happens, I use a very easy a signal, and I want to send, the sender should send a 1, a 1, a minus 1, and if the sender sends this, then he starts again with a 1, 1, minus 1, and so on. If I would have an oscilloscope, the signal would looks like this. This is the 1. Here comes the next 1. And now it goes down to minus 1 and up again here to the next 1. And from here it comes from minus 1. So 1. 1, minus 1. The duration from here of the duration of 1 bit is 104 microseconds. And now I assume that on the perimeter wire following happens. If I send a 1, the current goes in this direction. And if I send a minus 1, the current flows in this direction. So this current produces a magnetic field around the perimeter wire. And this magnetic field has a direction. And if the current flows in this direction of the 1, the magnetic field goes clockwise, I would say here. Yes, okay. This direction. And if I have a minus 1, the direction is the opposite way, I would say it's counterclockwise. That's not so nice here. Okay, this is the other direction. Okay, so what do we need on the robot to receive the signal? We need first a coil. The magnetic field goes then through this coil and induces a current. So the coil is connected to an amplifier, which is a gain of 200. Amplifier, okay, 100. And the amplifier is then connected to a microcontroller. Microcontroller to an analog in. And lock in. So let's see how the signal looks like at the output of the coil or at the output of the amplifier. I would say, okay, so we start with a one and the magnetic field goes through the coil in this direction. The changing of the magnetic field induces a current in the coil, and let's draw it again. We get here now the one amplitude. The duration is also 104 microseconds. And now we send this one, and now we send another one, but there is no change in the magnetic field because we have only a flank will produce a change in the magnetic field, and therefore we have here a zero. We have here no amplitude. So this amplitude here we received is produced by this flank here. And in order we have now between the first one and the second one no flank and no change in the magnetic field. Therefore we don't induce current in the coil, and therefore we don't see any signal here. But now, after the second one, we go down to minus one and receive then here an amplitude. And then here starts the signal from the beginning, and therefore we get here and the next amplitude and so on, zero and so on. So if you want to take a look at the signal you received with the oscilloscope and compare the sended signal with the received signal, you should remember this, that if you send a 1-1 or minus 1, we will always see a zero here.